Hello, my Galvanize family. My name is Rachel Vigil, and I had a chance to talk with Julie Stewart Binks. You may have seen her in studio at CBS Sports, or you may have seen her on the stage doing stand-up comedy. We had a chance to talk about how stand-up is helping her be a better broadcaster, how social media is playing a crucial role in her career today, and how sometimes you just have to pay your dues. Check out a few snippets of our interview right now. Let's go ahead and start off first question. You've worked for a bunch of different networks. What would you say would have to be the biggest lessons that you've learned?
I guess it's sort of hard to sort of categorize it all, but I guess the biggest thing would be that it is hard. Like, it has been extremely hard. And just when I sort of start to think everything's coming together and I start to feel comfortable in my workplace, like, the rug comes out from underneath me and, oh, you know, it's cuts, it's, you know, it's cuts, there's like downsizing, and then you got to find a new job, or you're not part of their plans, like a new boss comes in and they're like, yeah, we're going to go with sort of new people we like. And it's so weird, like you think when you're in school, oh, okay, I'm going to go intern, I'm going to go do my master's, I'm going to do all these things, like a million unpaid internships, I'll get a job and then kind of work my way there. But then it's never this direct path. And like, I've lived in 3 different countries, 8 cities, and even now I'm 31. And for the last 10 months, like, I didn't even know if I was going to be able to get a job in the industry. And I was like, this is so weird. I've worked for 2 national networks. Why isn't this sort of like happening a little bit quicker? The thing is, honestly, at the end of the day, like, I look at myself now, and even from when I was doing local TV in Canada, it would just be like, just stick with it. Like, it is so hard. It is long nights. It's small towns. It's doing everything on your own. It's feeling like, am I getting anywhere? But you are. Like, even in the smallest way possible, you are. And you just never know who's watching. And work ethic is like the number one thing I always pride myself on, because like, I didn't grow up in the States. I didn't go to a college that everyone knows. I kind of am like, I always feel a little bit at a disadvantage, but I think like, I know I can outwork all these people if you just let me have the opportunity. So work ethic, being okay with the process, like don't freak out that you don't have the dream job right now. Like, it's, everything is a step in the right direction. And if you're working hard to get there, you're on the path there. And then to just treat people well, you never know. And this isn't just for yourself, but like, everyone is going to come in and out of your life multiple times in this industry, and just don't burn any bridges whatsoever. Even if someone's treating you poorly one day and you're like, you know what, you kind of have to bite the bullet on some stuff. And a thick skin is so important too, especially as you mentioned, with dealing with coaches who are hot-headed, dealing with players who are hot-headed, having a thick skin, not letting it get to you personally, and being able to kind of like, yeah, you know, you want to be yourself, but you do kind of have to put on a facade at some points too. So yeah, it's tough, but it's kind of like you got to come to battle.
I guess, what kind of role does social media play now? I know you do a lot on Instagram stories and Twitter.
I think it's pivotal. I think it's probably number one, if anything. You know, especially, you know, everyone talks about, oh, people don't watch TV anymore, people blah, blah, blah. People do watch TV, especially they will watch a game. Like, the game will never change. It'll just be on a different medium. But people know what I do because of my Instagram stories, because of my Instagram posts and my Twitter. Like, my friends don't see me on TV or on a game. Like, very rarely they'll see me, but I'll post the stuff online. So even I talk to some of my friends at ESPN, like, they're like, people don't see me when I do it, but they'll post all their clips on social media because that's where people are going to see it. So, you know, you do kind of have to play the game of putting up posts and like promoting yourself. And like, I took some pictures today on my show to be like, you know, you kind of have to keep relevant. And I talked with a friend who used to work with at Fox, and he's like, you got to post at least 2 times a day on like social media, on Instagram and like Snapchat, which I don't do, to kind of like keep your story as like the first one up there. Cause then people will like always see it. Like, oh, I didn't even think about it that way. But kind of remind people, you have so many executives follow you. Like, I have so many executives follow me. And even I have a couple jobs right now. My most recent show that I was just talking about, the executive was like, oh, you know, I think you'd be really good for the show because they follow you on Instagram and like, you have a very good and fun personality. I'm like, wow, that's kind of weird and also scary, right? It makes you think, okay, you know, I'll keep my things in check. But also, everyone's looking for authenticity. They're looking for fun. They're looking for things that will grab eyeballs. So if you can find a way to show you can do that with sports, if that's what you want. Like, you have to figure out what your brand is and, like, what do I want people to think of me as? Mm-hmm. And I didn't really want to do sideline reporting anymore. And so I kind of transitioned a little bit to doing more comedy and more personality. And that's what people are starting to like see of me, because that's all my social.